Hello, my name is Chris Hammond. I'm the Director of Training with DotNetNuke Corporation. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about adding a child portal into an existing DotNetNuke installation. And in a previous video, we went through the process of adding a parent portal. Now, the difference between a parent and a child portal is the configuration that a parent portal requires with your domain, with DNS, and also within IIS, so the web server. A child portal is actually much easier to create. In order to create a portal, we need to be logged in as a host or a super user account. Now, we already have two portals currently created in our website, one being located at localhost/dotnetnuke, the other one being located at www.dotnetnukedemo.com. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to create a child portal underneath of dotnetnukedemo.com. Now, just because it's a child portal doesn't mean it's going to share any users or content with its parent portal. The child notion is just the URL that you access. It's a folder off of an existing alias in DotNetNuke. So the process of creating that child portal is fairly straightforward. We're going to switch over here to our current website. You can see we're currently logged in with a super user account, and we're going to navigate to the host portals page. Now from the portals page, we're going to choose the actions menu. And we're going to add a new portal. We need to make sure we choose the child option. Now, when we choose the child option, you'll notice that our portal alias gets populated. We can go ahead and type in the child information off of that existing portal alias. So we're going to have a child portal at www.netnukedemo.com/child. And we'll go ahead and give our portal a name and a description. Now, when you're creating a portal, you do have to define a template. There's one template provided with DotNetNuke. You can create additional templates as well. And then we need to go ahead and define the administrator account for this portal. Now we cannot reuse the admin account from one of the previous portals. So I'm going to create a new admin account called admin3 with a fake email address here. Need to define a password. Now when we go through and we click create portal, we are going to get an error message back that tells us that the portal is created, but it was unable to send an email to the administrator. That's because we don't currently have email configured within this particular DotNetNuke website. But we also get a link here that will allow us to navigate to that newly created portal. So we can simply click on that link, and that will take us to the newly created portal. Now, because both the parent portal, DotNetNukeDemo.com, and the child portal were created with the same template, the websites look exactly the same. We can tell they're different, however, by going to the admin menu and going to the user accounts page. Here on the child portal, in the user accounts page, we have a username listed called admin3. And if we were to change the URL and navigate back to just dotnetnukedemo.com, we can come into the admin user accounts page. And here we would find we have an account with a username of admin2. So users are not shared across the portals. Now, if we want to access that child portal again, we'd simply come in here and on the end of the URL type in child. So that's a very basic introduction to child portals in DotNetNuke. In a future video, we'll show you how you can convert a child portal into a parent portal in DotNetNuke. It's a pretty straightforward process. In the meantime, though, please feel free to check out our DotNetNuke training page located under the Resources tab on DotNetNuke.com. There you'll find a variety of free training videos as well as an upcoming schedule of our online instructor-led training, as well as information about our on-site and online training options. Again, this was Chris Hammond with DotNetNuke Corporation. Thanks for watching the video.